Hey, what's up, everybody? Adam here from Toxic Reality Radio. I just wanted to go over some things re in regards to the Blood Electrifier from the Beck protocol video I made over a year ago. As quick as possible, some questions. Well, first and foremost, I want to apologize for still not making a do-it-yourself video. It's just time-consuming. I don't have the equipment right now to do it, or I could have a camera overhead so you guys could see step-by-step on how to do it. Secondly, I just want to cover the electrode part. Oh God, these birds drive me freaking crazy. It's like when you start talking, they talk right back at They're beautiful birds, but anyway, so the first thing I want to talk about is the electrodes. Okay. Oh, look, now the dogs take over. Hey! So the first thing I want to talk about and stuff is the electrodes. Okay, these are stainless steel. This is a stainless steel cotter pin, basically, that you can find at your local Home Depot or home center, home improvement center, or store. Usually, it looks like these two are put together and it has a loop at the bottom. You can cut the loop off and stuff. I drill a hole in each one of these at the bottom with a very, very small drill bit. It is kind of hard to drill into stainless steel, okay, so it takes some time. Then I actually loop my wire through the hole and then put a little bead of solder in each one of them. And then, of course, I heat shrink, use heat shrink on the wires and stuff to make them nice and clean. The other thing that comes up regarding my Electrifier, back when I made that initial video and stuff, I did not have the colloidal silver generator as part of my box. I did do that way after the fact. People ask and stuff if it's a separate thing from the circuit and stuff, and it is a separate thing from the circuit. However, when you look at the circuit schematic and stuff, it shows that it's part of it simply because it's getting the power from the same 9-volt batteries that you use for your blood electrifier. Okay, so this headphone jack here is for the electrifier. It goes to the electrodes that I showed you with a headphone jack, and then this one over here. I don't have the headphone jack for that. That has my two alligator clips that basically go onto my two silver electrodes and stuff into my water. And the reason for the bulb, so people understand it, is if you have a closed circuit for whatever reason, whether your electrodes are too close together in the water, or when the colloids start actually making inside the water, you'll see on the electrodes and stuff that it almost looks like little creatures that are coming off and stuff that branch across from one electrode to another. And if it closes the circuit, this lights up. Okay, as soon as that lights up, that closes your circuit, and you're no longer making colloids. So you just kind of brush them off and continue making your colloidal silver. You got to clean that water after a while and stuff. And I made this yesterday. Is about half a gallon of silver, colloidal silver. And if I had a laser pointer, you'd be able to see it's kind of a cloudy white. That took me about 30 minutes to make, okay? I know it's a lot of people out there taking hours and stuff, and that's not the right thing. Okay, so the other thing I wanted to talk about really quick too is over on my website, toxicrealityradio.com. We have our shows here on the very first page, but you know, for you guys, go to over to the Bob Beck protocol, and at the very top of the page, I have the Bob Beck papers here. Okay, take back your power. This packet is full of everything that he ever put out. Okay, and I'm talking about everything. The initial package that I first found online years ago and stuff did not have all the stuff that this one has. Okay, so I suggest downloading it. It's here for free. Just share it with your friends. For people who are putting one together, follow this little animation here that I put on the right. Okay, I do suggest that you use this, but do not stray away from the original schematic parts list. That's the reason mine, when I put mine together initially with my breadboard and stuff, I had a lot of issues where it was not working or whatever, or I was actually getting a current out and stuff, but it wasn't a pulsating current because I wasn't using the right LED. I mean, there's so many things that make this thing work the way Bob Beck meant it to work, okay? And you cannot stray away from the original parts list and how to put it together. And like I said, this is a perfect way. If you have any issues with that, please drop me a line. We can talk about it. I could tell you what my experiences are and what I deviated from and stuff. So as far as my initial video, I guess I'll be taking it down soon or replacing it with this one or replacing it with something similar to it, showing what I've done, the schematics and all that kind of stuff. I mean, not the schematics, but what I built and how I built it. And that's about it in regards to that. Okay, so for the most part, anybody else that's interested in different type of shows and stuff regarding similar stuff like Bob Beck, Bob Beck did come on this show back in the 80s, in the early 80s. It was called Open Mind. It was a talk show here in LA with Bill Jenkins on CBS, KBC Radio. Talk radio. I have a few of the shows down here in regards to other things like ELF, the Philadelphia Experience, Roswell, things like that, Crystal Healing, and I'm sure you'll find these very in-depth and useful. Okay. So with that, I guess I will let you guys go, and we'll be talking soon.